Bismillahirrahmanirrahim and assalamu alaikum students. I hope all of you are good and doing well at home. So students, if you remember, we have started our chapter number 2, system of real numbers, exponents and radicals. And so far we have done total 6 exercises from the chapter, and this chapter belongs to the arithmetic section. So what I want from all of you is to open your arithmetic copy and book. Okay, open chapter number 2 and open your arithmetic copy, because in the next slide I am going to tell you what is our today's index. Okay, so today we are going to again start from exercise number 2.7, and this is our index for today's lecture. Exercise number 2.7, question number 8. So kindly copy down the index. Okay, Hafsa, beta, whenever class is going to start, so you should have your copy, each and everything with all of you. Copy, book, pen, pencil, eraser. You know, we have to do classwork. So you should open your books and copies before this lecture. Okay, now when you copy down the index, so please tell me done. Okay, please write it down in the chat box that you have done. Okay, madam. Finally, write down the index. Everyone, exercise number 2.7, question number 8. Exercise number 2.7, question number 8. Done. Okay, now move on to the next one. Now, this is the example that I am going to explain, okay, for question number 8. This is the example for question number 8. Understand? This is example. And I'm going to explain this example with the help of video. So please tell me, is video clear or not? Understand? Clear hai? Okay, now this is example. Okay, so please do not copy down this question in your copy. Okay, just listen. Now, before, how will you start? Okay, it may be due to internet connection. So much blur. Why blur, beta? Because up now, check now, tell me. Okay, that okay, 1 minute, students, 1 minute. It is because black pen, so maybe it is not clear. When I'm going to solve it with blue pen, so hopefully you can see this. Okay, I can understand that you cannot see that this is N. Okay, so it may be due to the black pen. Lines bhi blur hai. Beta, meri taraf nahi hai. Okay, now I'm about to start the lecture. Now what you will do, first you will write down the date here. What is today? Today is 12 1 21. Okay, then you will write here exercise number 2.7, and this is question number 8, example. This is example, okay? This is question number 8, example. Now, what you will do, what you have here, PL divided by PM, okay? And it has whole power L plus M. Then multiply by PM divided by PN, and it has whole power M plus N. Then PN divided by PL, and it has whole power N plus N. Now, what you will do, you will simplify it. And how will you simplify it? As you can see, these two terms are same, bases are same. So when the bases are same, and Fatma, please listen, okay? If the two things are same, if the bases are same and different powers, and they are dividing with each other, so what you will do, you will simply subtract it. This is L and this is M. So what you will do, I'm going to write it down with blue pen. So hopefully it will be clear. This is P, this is capital L, okay? Divided by P, capital M. It has whole power L plus M. Then sign of multiplication. Then you have P whole power M divided by P whole power N. Sorry, not whole power. This is power. P power of P is N. Then it has whole power M plus N. Okay. Then you have sign of multiplication. Then what do you have? P. Okay. Small n, power small n divided by P, which is a base and it has power L, small l, divided by N plus L, which is the whole power. This is the whole power N plus N. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Understand? It may be due to black pen. Okay, black pen maybe is not visible to all of you. Now I'm going to explain it with blue pen. So hopefully it is clear, right? Understand? Now it is clear. Okay, now listen. What you will do, thank you students, now listen. Now what you have, same base, okay, and different powers, and they are dividing with each other. So if you have same base and different powers, so what you will do, the power of the denominator will be subtracted. So how will you write it down here? Simply you will write bracket. You will take the same base, which is P, okay? Then you will write here L. This is plus M. Jab upar lenge, it will be minus M. Understand? And then it has whole power, which is L plus M. Understand? Now, next is the sign of multiplication. Clear? Then what you have? PM and PN. So again, you will take the same base, which is P. Then this base M. And here you have N. Upar leke aayenge, so it will be minus N. Bracket close, and it has whole power M plus N. Clear? Is it clear? Okay, thank you, Fatma. Now move on to the last term. Here you have the last term, which is, again, we will take the same base, which is P, and then we will write here N minus L. Understand? And then you will write here the whole power, which is N plus L. Understand? Now, what you will do, you have power of the power. So if you have power to the power, so what you will do, powers will be multiplied with each other. So this, my L minus M will be multiplied with L plus M. So how will you gonna write it? You will simply write is equals to sign, your base, which is P, and then you will write in bracket L minus M, bracket close, then L plus M. Understand? This is your power. Clear? Move on to the next one, sign of multiplication. Simply you will write your base, which is P, then M minus N. So in the bracket, you will write M minus N, bracket close, then you will multiply it with M plus N. Understand? Then sign of multiplication, then P, then you have N minus L, bracket close, N plus n. Understand? Now look at here. Here you have l minus m, l plus m. Two brackets are multiplying with each other that have same variables. One is, but one bracket has minus sign and one bracket has plus sign. So here you will remember the formula, which is a square minus b square is equals to a minus b multiplied by a plus b. Remember this formula. Do you remember this formula? You have a formula a minus b, a plus b. If you have the two terms that are multiplying with each other, so it will be equals to a squared minus b squared. So what you will do, you will write it down this form in this form. Okay, so how will you write it here? Simply you will write here b. Okay, here a will be equals to l. So you will write l square minus formula ka minus a. Okay, l square minus m square. Understand? Then sign of multiplication, here you will also apply the formula. Okay, a is m or b is n, so you will write base b and simply you will write m square minus n square. Ye wali cheez hai. Okay, then you have sign of multiplication. Understand? Then this p, and simply you will write this is n, which is a, so you will write n square minus l square. Is it clear? Now what you will do, simply look at here. What you have here, same base. Okay, which is the same base? Your base is p. Here you have base is p and your base is p, and all the same bases are multiplying with each other. So you will say that when the bases are same, so their powers will be added. Remember the concept, same base power will add. Okay, so same base is p, and now simply you will add their powers. How will you add their powers? You will write each power inside the bracket. So first you have l square minus m square. Okay, sign of addition. The next power, which is m square minus n square, bracket close. Then sign of addition. Now the last power, which is n square minus l square, bracket close. Clear hai ye? Is this clear? Is it clear? Okay, now what we will do, we will open the bracket. As you can see, each bracket has plus sign, so the inside sign will not be changed. Jo sign hai wo change nahi honge. Simply you will open the bracket without changing the sign. Now what I am going to do, I am going to write this thing here. Okay, look at here. What we will do, I will write it here is equals to p. Okay, now first you have l square minus m square, so I'm going to write here l square minus m square. Then you have plus, here you have plus, then you will write m square minus n square. Okay, then you will write it here plus m square minus n square, and the last we have this one plus n square minus l square. Okay, so you will write it here plus n square minus l square. Understand? Okay, now we will cut the, now look at here, this is plus l square and this is minus l square. Okay, all the things are same, coefficient and powers are variable and powers are same, and one has plus sign and one has minus sign, so ye se cancelled. Here you have minus m square and plus m square, so it will be cancelled. Here you have minus n square and plus n square, so it will be cancelled. Understand? Now what will be left here? Obviously, which power is left? Nothing is left here, so you will say zero. Okay, power is zero now, and you know if any variable has zero power, so it will be equals to one, so your answer will be equals to one. Is it clear? Now what you will do, look at here. First you will copy down the question. Then as you can see here, you have the same base, so if you have same base, so their power will be subtracted. When you will subtract the power? When the bases are dividing with each other. Okay, now simply you will subtract the power. You will write base only one time, same base, and then you will write l minus m. Okay, and it has whole power, which is l plus m. Then move on to the next one. Here you have m and n. So what you will do, you will subtract the powers because the base is same, m minus n, and it has whole power m plus n. Okay. Inside the bracket, you have the last one, which is pn divided by pl. Same base, so power will be subtracted, pn minus l, and it has whole power n plus l. Understand? Now, what you have here, power of the power. So if you have power of the power, so their powers will be multiplied with each other. So what you will do, you will write your base p here and then multiply this lm with lm, l minus m and l plus m. So inside the bracket you will write both the powers. Okay, same will be done with this one, m minus n. So inside the bracket you will write m minus n, and then inside the bracket you will write m plus n. Then you will then with this one as well, n minus l inside the bracket multiplied with the second power, which is n plus l. Okay, now as you can see here, this is l minus m and l plus m. So here we will apply this formula, which is a square minus, okay, which is a square minus b square, which is equals to a minus b a plus b. Means if you have two variables and they are multiplying in such a way that in first bracket you have minus sign and in second bracket you have plus sign, so it will be equals to a square and b square. Means you have to take the square of term a and you have to take the square of term b as well. Okay, so here your term a is l, so you will take the square of l. Inside the formula you have minus sign. Minus sign. So you will write minus here, and then term B is B, M. So you will write M square. Understand? Same will be done with V. Here you have P, then you will write M square minus N square, multiply by P. Here you have N and L, N and L. So N square minus L square. Now, what you have same base. Okay, your base is same here, that is P. Understand? Your base is same here, that is P. Now, if the base is same, so the powers will be added. So this is one power, this is second power, this is third power of V. Okay, so what you will do, you will separately add the powers inside the bracket. So inside the bracket, you will write L square minus M square plus M square minus N square plus N square minus. Now simply you will open the bracket with the help of this plus sign. It has plus sign, so no need to change any sign here. So simply you will write here in this way, and then obviously one has plus sign and it has minus sign, so it will be cancelled. So nothing will be left in the power. So your power here is zero. So if there any variable which has zero power, so it will be equals to one. And now this is your answer. Now you may start your question number 8. Understand? Now, start question number 8. Everyone. Start question number 8. This is the example that I have explained. Now, this is the question number 8, exercise number 2.7. Kindly start it. Done. Who has done? All of you have done. Okay, now I'm going to check your video answer then. Okay, all of you are saying done, done. Okay, now turn on your videos, everyone. Then if you have done, so please turn on your videos. Everyone, turn on your video. If you have done this question, so kindly turn on your videos, everyone. Okay, who is this one? This is Rumaisa. Just a minute. Okay, now this is Rumaisa's answer. Rumaisa, please show me. Okay, now next is Fatma. Now, who is this? This is Fatma. Okay, Fatma is still doing. Okay, now I'm going to check the answer of Lujain. Now this is Lujain's answer. Okay, Lujain, please isko straight kijiye. Okay. Why you are writing here zero? What is this one, beta? What is this, Rumaisa? Sorry, Lujain. What is this? 0 is equals to 1, please do not write it down in this way. No, do not write this way, in this way. Okay, now Talha, I'm checking your answer. Okay, Talha, very good, Talha. Please show me the answer, Talha. Final answer. Okay, that's good. Okay, now Mariam, I'm checking your answer. Okay, now this is Mariam's answer. Okay, Mariam, just a minute, please. Okay, that is very good. Now I'm checking the Shahira's answer. Okay, Shahira is still doing. Shahira and Abdul Rahman, both of you are doing. Okay, that's good. Okay, Rumaisa. Okay, Rumaisa, your answer is right. Very good, Rumaisa. Okay, Fatima is still doing. Okay, Faleha. Okay, that's good. Faleha, very good, beta. Okay, Ishal, I'm going to check your answer as well. This is Ishal. Ishal, please. Lujain. Okay, that's good. Okay, Varda Gul. Very good, Varda. Very neat and tidy work. Varda, please erase it. X is equals to X 0 is equals to 1. This is wrong. Beta, please correct it. This thing is wrong. Okay, Maida. Okay, yes, Maida, you are right. Okay, that's good. Okay, no, Ishal. Okay, now Ishal, I'm checking your answer. Ishal, please show the answer. Okay, now answer, please. Ishal, answer, please. Last steps. Okay, that's good. That's good. Now next is Abdul Ahad. Okay, very good, Abdul Ahad. Okay, Hafsa. Abdul Rahman, I'm checking your answer as well. Just a minute. Hafsa, I can't see your video. Okay, what you have done so far, Hafsa? Okay, that's good. Okay, Abdul Rahman. Okay, Hafsa. Abdul Rahman, I can't see your video. Okay, Fatma and Shiza. Okay, now I'm moving to the Fatma. Okay, Abdul Rahman, just a minute. Abdul Rahman, you have missed a lot of steps. So please try to do each and every step. As I can see, there are very less steps in your answer. So, okay, Shiza. That's good. Hamza. Okay, Hamza, very good. Okay, now I'm stop sharing all of your videos. Okay, I'm stop sharing all of your videos. So, Ali Rao, okay, it's okay. Now, if we have a lot of time, so what can we do? What can we do? Okay, please turn off your videos, everyone. That's good. Now, as we have a lot of time, so we can start question number 9. So please write down in the index question number 9. As we have a lot of time, so we can start question number 9. So write down in the index question number 9. This is not question number 9. This is example. Understand? So in the index, please add question number 9. When done, so please tell me inside the chat box. Question number 9, and copy down question number 9. Okay, one more thing. If something will be left, so we will continue from the next class. Okay, so please do not get confused now. I'm going to start the video of mine. Just a minute. Okay, copied. Hamza Madni, please stop your video. Now look at here. So this is the example. Okay, this is example. Please listen. This is example, and I know it is not clear, so I'm going to write it with blue pen. Is it clear or not? Please tell me. Is it clear or not? Clear? Not clear? Okay, it's okay. That's good. Now look at here. What you will do, again, same criteria. Okay, please look at here. You have the same criteria, same base. Base is same, so power will be subtracted. Base is same, power will be subtracted. Base is same, power will be subtracted. Right, so in the next, how will you, I'm going to start, I'm simply write here x. I will simply write here the same base, which is x, and I'm going to write here what, a minus b, understand? And then it has whole power, which is this one, which is a plus b minus c, understand? Then the next you have again the same base, which is x. So inside the right bracket, you will write your same base, which is x, and they are dividing. So you will write b minus c. It will become b minus c, bracket close. And it has whole power, which is b plus c minus a. Understand? Now the last one is this one here. You have x, which is the same base. So simply you will write here x, and simply you will write c minus a. And then you will write here the whole power, which is a plus c minus b. Please tell me, is this a step clear? Is this a step clear? Step clear or not? Okay, what will be the next step? Power to the power, power to the power, power to the power. So what you will do, powers will be multiplied with each other. And you know how will you multiply the powers? You will simply put both the powers inside the bracket. So when you will write base here, okay, and inside the bracket you will write a minus b, and then a plus b minus c, right? Then here again the sign of multiplication, and now this is your x, small x, so try to make a small x. Okay, then you have b minus c, so inside the bracket you will write b minus c, and then you will write b plus c minus a, bracket close. Understand? Now last is this one, sign of multiplication, and you have here x, understand? Inside the bracket you will write c minus a, and the last is this one, which is a plus c minus b. I know it is not visible. Obviously, I do not have much space, but this is a plus b, a plus c minus b. Now listen, what you have here. This is the very important step, because here you have two terms and here you have three terms, and you have to multiply these terms with this one. Okay, now I'm going to explain this step in another page. Okay, look at here. What you have, a minus b. What do you have? Look at here. I'm going to explain it here. What do you have? A minus b, and multiply with a plus b minus c. Yehi hai aapke paas? Aisa hi hai? Okay. Now, how will you multiply? First, you will multiply this a with this one. Okay. So, what it will become? It will become a square. Understand? Now you are going to multiply this plus a with this one, plus plus, so it will become plus a b. Understand? Now you are going to multiply this plus a with this minus c, so plus minus will be minus, and a multiplied by c will be
A, C.
Understand? Now, next here you have minus B. Here you have plus A. So minus plus will be minus, and B multiplied by A will be AB. Understand? Clear? Next is minus B is going to multiply with this one. So minus plus minus, and B multiplied by B will be B square. Understand? And the last one is this C, but you have minus and minus. So minus minus will be plus, and B multiplied by C will be BC. Is it clear? Class, clear? Similarly, what you will do, I'm going to repeat this step again and again. Here you have B minus C. Next we have B minus C multiplied by B plus C minus A. So how will you gonna multiply it? It's simple. Simple, you will apply the same method. Look at here. What you have here? B. So B multiplied by B will be B square. Then plus B plus C. So you are going to multiply it in this one. So it will be plus BC. Okay. Then plus minus. Okay. Plus minus will be minus. And here you have this one. B multiplied by A will be AB. Understand? Now we are going to multiply this one. This minus with this plus sign. So minus plus minus. Okay. C multiplied by B will be BC. Understand? Then you have minus plus again. It will be minus. Understand? So C multiplied by C will be, when you are going to multiply this, C will be this C. So it will be C square. Understand? And what you have lost, simply this minus sign. So minus minus will be plus. So C multiplied by A will be AC. Understand? Now, last word, you have this one. C minus A multiplied by A plus C minus B. Okay, so minus B. So it will be equals to what? Again, C multiplied by A will be AC. Okay, then plus plus plus. Then C multiplied by C will be C square. Then plus minus minus. So C multiplied by B will be BC. Similarly, this minus will be multiplied with this minus. So minus minus minus. A multiplied by A will be A square. Understand? Similarly, minus plus minus. And A multiplied by C will be AC. Understand? And then this minus minus will be plus. And A multiplied by B will be AB. Clear? This step is clear or not? Is this step clear or not? Clear. Now, simply what you will do, simply you will write the answers of this one. I'm going to write all these answers here. So when you will multiply this one, so what is the answer? You have A square plus AB minus AC minus AB minus B square plus BC, then multiply by X. Okay, what is the power? You have B square plus BC minus AB minus BC minus C square plus AC, and last sign of multiplication, X. So what is the answer of this one? AC plus C square minus BC minus A square minus AC plus AB. Clear? Now, what you will see that this is plus AB and this is minus AB. So, you will cancel. Okay, plus AB minus AB. Here, as you can see, you have plus BC and here you have minus BC. It will be cancelled. Here you have plus AC and minus AC. So it will be cancelled. Now what is left here? We will be left with A square minus
a square minus ac minus b square plus bc multiply by x b square, okay, then minus ab minus c square plus ac, sign of multiplication, then x, here you have c square minus bc minus a square plus ab. Understand? Now what you have, same bases are same, so power will be added. Simply you will write here the same base, which is x. Okay, same base, so simply you will add their powers inside the bracket. You will write a square minus ac minus b square plus bc, then sign of addition, then you will write here b square minus ab minus c square plus ac, sign of addition, and the last is c square minus bc minus a square plus ab. Understand? Now all the brackets has plus sign, so simply you will open the bracket, you will write here x a square minus ac minus b square plus bc, then the sign of addition, plus b square minus ab minus c square plus, phir plus c square minus bc minus a square plus ab. Now as you can see, all the things are cancelling with each other. What you have, this is plus a square, this is minus a square, ye cancel. This is minus ac, this is plus ac, ye cancel. This is minus b square, this is plus b square, ye cancel. This is plus bc, this is minus bc, it will be cancelled. Then minus ab plus ab, ab cancel. Minus c square plus c square, everything will be cancelled. So what you will left with? You will left with the power 0 and it will be equals to 1. This is the bracket, okay? So your answer will be 1 here. I know it is a little bit difficult, so that's why I'm just explaining here, okay? I'm just explaining here. Those who are saying that they have done, so I will give you some time tomorrow. I'm going to repeat this question tomorrow as well, okay? Okay, now those, how many of you have done? Okay, Lujain, have you done? Oh, very good. Uh-huh, Shahira, Abdul Rahman, both of you have done. Fatma Abdul Karim is on last step. Okay, time is about almost over. So I will check your answers tomorrow. Okay, students, I will check your answers tomorrow. So this was the basically example, and you have to attempt this question. This is question number 9. Okay, and I will check all of your answers is tomorrow. Understand? Okay, if you want to ask anything, do you have any question? Which slide we take? Okay, I'm going to show you the example again.